Hello and welcome to the world of Movie Community College. The professor and the warrior queen have been working hard to bring you some great new videos. Please make sure to like, subscribe and smash the bell. For now, let's just enjoy the fabulous video.
What's up? I enjoy these types of videos that kind of give you the science or the reason behind the tradition or the practice. And this was something like the scientific reasons behind Hindu practices. Well, let's just look at the title. The Science Behind Popular Indian Traditions, a documentary film. Let's take a look at it, shall we?
India, pristine ground of spirituality, a land with a 7,000-year-old history, a land held tight to its ancient traditions, embedded with fruits of its deep-rooted culture, passed on through generations, sentiments intact. Despite having witnessed or belonged to this society with innumerable traditions, we lack the understanding of the logical reason behind several rituals and customs and brand them superstitious and meaningless. We have shelved away many of these anecdotes passed on by our forefathers with years of increasing westernization, a lot of it because of sheer ignorance. Have we ever wondered why certain things are devised the way they are? Why do we have specifications to every ritual
That's
followed?
Pretty cool.
Idol worship is a form of prayer, but what is the reason behind installing these idols in magnificently constructed temples? What is the purpose of temples at all?
I know.
Temples are constructed in zones where positive vibrations from the earth's magnetic and electric fields can be tapped in abundance. The peak of this energy is felt at the Garbhagraha or the Sanctum Sanctorum, where the deity is installed. People are asked to walk barefoot in temples so that the radiation is easily absorbed. Men are advised to visit temples bare-chested as the human hair has the capacity to absorb positive energy. Women are asked to wear gold ornaments when they visit the temples, as gold is one of the best absorbers and radiators of positive energy. This is why many temple vimanas are made of gold too. We walk around the Sanctum Sanctorum to enable a state of equilibrium for the brain by its movement around a source of positivity. These are some of the reasons behind the sense of serenity that fills a person from within whenever they visit a temple, regardless of their belief in God. An unsaid rule from the ancient times is that the temple should be the tallest construction in that particular town or city. We see this rule in prevalence in the Agraharam style of civilization in the rural areas. The reason commonly stated is that God is the supreme and hence the temple must be the tallest. Actual reason behind this practice is the absorbing power of the temple Gopuram. The gopuram is usually filled with paddy on the inside, which is an excellent absorbent of shock waves. Wherever lightning hits the village, the rays are diverted to the gopuram and the excess harmful rays are transmitted to the earth.
Makes sense.
Beneficial cosmic rays from the atmosphere are retained by the paddy and radiated inside the temple. There have been debates regarding conducting abhishekams for stone idols in temples. These age-old granite idols have the tendency to develop cracks on aging. Regular contact with agents such as milk, honey, and oil help in keeping the idol intact, thus preserving these ancient sculptures. Another interesting observation is that the base on which these idols are mounted is made up of a specific alloy of gold, silver, and traces of lead, which have medicinal properties when combined with milk and honey. This is why milk and Panchamritam from the Abhishekam that are distributed are said to have special properties that cure many diseases. Earlier, when the literacy rate in the country was much less than it is now, instilling a fear of God was the only way to put forth scientific ideas and practices involving logical reasoning. We have unfortunately forgotten the essence of such genius measures and brushed them away as superstitious. The Ganesha sitting beneath the peepal tree or the Arasamara Vinayagar is a widely popular deity of worship among women. There is a common belief that women who are unable to conceive will be able to do so if they visit this Vinayagar every day in the early hours of the morning with wet clothes after a shower and walk in circles around the tree. The secret behind the miraculous success of this practice is the peepal tree. This tree is known to give out high amounts of oxygen and very minimal amounts of carbon dioxide through the day. Oxygen is said to be the best cure for hormonal imbalances in the body and naturally brings undernourished organs back to normalcy. Gradually, the hormones in the uterus start functioning routinely and the woman is able to conceive. Wet clothes help in better absorption of oxygen, thus ensuring maximum benefit of the ritual. The motive behind placing the pillar is to convince people to follow it in the name of God, giving them a reason to diligently
pursue
it.
Are those the babies they want? I know why you feed crows. Because crows won't eat poison. Professor!
In Indian tradition, crows are given special importance as they are considered ancestors. After the meal for the day is prepared, a portion of every dish is kept outside for the crows to feast on so that the members of the family have the satisfaction of having fed their ancestors. Are they really our ancestors or have our forefathers just been spinning yarns? There is an interesting reason behind this age-old tradition. Earlier on, when there was no electricity and hence no proper light in the early hours of the morning, people were doubtful of the food they cooked. The crow, as we all know, is a creature that can eat almost anything and that which never refuses food. Interestingly, it can sense the presence of any kind of poison in food.
Yes, yes.
It simply refuses food
if
it senses
Indian,
poison
in
it. People from the ancient times happened to use the crow as a tester for food smartly without harming it.
Pretty ingenious.
When it comes to the food system, Indian cuisine is one of the most balanced regimens, including optimum quantities of all nutrients conceived into delicious dishes that are easily digestible. Our ancestors even had appropriate meal timings
really
devised to ensure proper and timely metabolism and digestion for
it's
adequate
so
energy to carry out
American
the task through the day.
Like, wow.
As an ancient custom says, the best kind of diet for any human being or living animal in a region is the diet consisting of foods grown in the same area. We have essentially evolved through the years to belong to a tropical climate and be accustomed to the foods and lifestyle offered by this region. With the arrival of foreign cultures and lifestyles, the concept of eating out was brought about with the expansion and trade of foreign cuisines, which sadly are not the best suited diets for the Indian stomach. Most importantly, eating outside food greatly disturbs the timing of meals. We may believe that the only consequences of ill-timed meals are acidity and gastroenteritis, but actually, the human body functions by a system of energy flow between organs.
There's one white dude, did you see
Ancient
him?
Scriptures of naturopathy and manuscripts of Ayurveda hold references to the organ clock.
Anakam. நம்மளோட உணவு மற்றும் வாழ்வியல் முறையில் ஆரோக்கியமாக வாழ்ந்துட்டு இருந்த நம்ம எந்த இடத்துல அதை தடம் மாறி இருந்தோம் தடம் மாறி நம்மளோட ஆரோக்கியத்தை இழந்துட்டோன்ற பார்க்கும்போது முதல்ல ஆர்கன் கிளாக் வைஸ்னு பன்னெண்டு ஆர்கனுக்கு 24 மணி நேரம் தன்னோட பீக் அவர்ஸில் அது வேலை செஞ்சுட்டு இருக்கும்போது தன் கழிவுகளை அது ஒழுங்காக வெளி நீக்கிட்டு இருந்தது. அந்தந்த நேரத்தில் அது அதோட கழிவுகளை வெளி நீக்க நம்ம இடம் கொடுக்காததன் பேரில் அந்த கழிவுகள் அதிகமாகி டாக்ஸினாக மாறி பிளட் கெமிஸ்ட்ரியை கெடுத்து ஸோ அசிடிட்டிக்காக அல்கலைனாக இருந்த உடல் நிலை வந்து அசிடிட்டிக்காக கன்வெர்ட் ஆகிடுச்சு. அசிடிட்டிக்காக கன்வெர்ட் ஆன உடனே உடலால் அந்த கழிவுகளை வெளியேற்ற முடியாததுனால உடம்பு தன்னோட ஆட்டோ இம்யூன் சிஸ்டத்தை இழந்தது. ஆட்டோ இம்யூன் சிஸ்டத்தை இழந்த உடனே தனக்குத்தானே புதுப்பிக்கும் தன்மையில் செல்கள் இருந்த நிலையை மாறி இப்போ செல்கள் வந்து இறந்த செல்கள் அதிகமாக ஸ்டோரேஜ் ஆக ஆரம்பிச்சது. நியூ செல் ஜென்ரேட் ஆகாமல் தான் நோய்கள் வர ஆரம்பித்தது. இதுக்காக பாரம்பரிய உணவு முறைகளில் நம்மளோட கலாச்சாரத்துலேயும் நம்மளோட வாழ்வியல் முறையிலையும் ஸோ உணவு மற்றும் வாழ்வியல் முறைன்னு வரும்போது ஸோ காலமும் உணவு முறையும் உழைப்பும் சரியான முறையில் இருந்ததுனால அவங்களுக்கு வாழ்க்கையில் இந்த நோய் என்ற ஒரு விஷயமே இல்லாமல் ஆரோக்கியத்தை மட்டுமே நோக்கி பயணம் பண்ணிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. ஸோ 12 ஆர்கனுக்கும் 24 மணி நேரம் டைம் கொடுத்துருக்கோம். அதில் ரொம்ப முக்கியமாக சொல்லணும்னா ஸோ லிவர் தன்னோட கழிவுகளை முழுமையாக வெளி நீக்கி உடம்புல இருக்க மொத்த ரத்தத்தையும் டயாலிசிஸ் பண்ணி ஸோ தன் கழிவுகளை வெளி நீக்கி பிளட் கெமிஸ்ட்ரியை ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ண வைக்கிறதுக்கு ரொம்ப முக்கியமான நேரமானது. ஸோ சாயந்தரம் 10 மணிலேருந்து 3-4 மணி வரும் யார் நல்லா ஆழ்ந்து தூக்கம் தூங்குறாங்களோ அவங்களுக்கு எந்த நோயும் வராது. ஸோ பிளட் ஆட்டோ டயாலிசிஸ் ப்ராசஸ். இதில் உணவின் 10 மணிக்கு தூங்க போனோம்னா நீங்கள் 7 மணிக்கு நிச்சயமாக சாப்பிட்ருக்கணும், உணவு முறையை முடிச்சிருக்கணும். 3 மணி நேரம் இடைவேளைக்கு பிறகு தூக்கம் இருந்தால் ஆழ்ந்த தூக்கம் வந்து லிவர் தன் எனர்ஜியை முழுமையாக பயன்படுத்தும். இந்த இடத்துல தான் நம்ம லிவர் எனர்ஜியை பயன்படுத்த தவறிட்டோம். அதனால தான் ஆட்டோ இம்யூன் சிஸ்டம் நமக்கு முழுமையாக லாஸ் ஆச்சு. ஸோ இப்போ இதுக்கு மறுபடியும் மருந்துகளை கொடுத்து குணப்படுத்த முடியுமான்னா எந்த காலகட்டத்திலும் மருந்தை எடுத்துட்டு உடம்பு குணப்படுத்தாது. இன்னொன்று உணவு வந்து மருந்தானால் உடல் மருத்துவர் ஆகிடும். அப்போ அந்த உணவுக்கு ரொம்ப முக்கியம் அல்கலைன் உணவுகள். இந்த அல்கலைன் உணவுகளை தான் நம்ம பாரம்பரியத்தில் வரகு, திணை, சாமை, குதிரைவாளி போன்ற அற்புதமான உணவுகளை பயன்படுத்த ஆரம்பித்தாங்க.
You can now see that almost every ancient Indian tradition has a scientific explanation behind it. Some of them are deeply spiritual and very much beyond the understanding of the common man.
I have
because of which they were linked to the concept
that,
of blind belief.
And it has to do with
After years of experience
stomach,
and observation,
so
our forefathers have drafted these traditions to be imbibed into societal living and lifestyles to ensure a healthy, peaceful living.
You know, live
so let's start looking
would,
deeper.
Ingest,
let's
you know,
start truly appreciating the riches we have
and,
been provided with.
And it helps to
let us look
my,
at our customs with
system.
Positive curiosity.
The things that me and the Warrior Queen were talking
After
about
all,
is,
isn't it our duty as the future
I
generation
very,
to carry them forward?
Schedule. Right? Sometimes I'm in bed by 5 p.m., but I'm up at midnight, right? Because I get up, I do my radio stuff, I do my YouTube, I get ready to go to work because I have a job. Like, I go to my job and I go and I call on my customers. And my job is not a typical, like, 9 to 5. I have an area and I have to go through each day in a different part of town and go service certain customers. And when I'm done, I'm done. So sometimes I can be done by 9 a.m. Sometimes it's 4 p.m., right? So whenever I'm done, I'm done. Then I make my commute home where the Warrior Queen will make dinner for us. And I have this bad habit of eating and going right to bed. And sometimes I get issues from that. And what he just said, it's like a light went off, dude. Are you serious? Because we were just talking like maybe I should like figure out to eat 2 hours before bed. But he's saying 3 hours before bed. I got to tell you, man, I think there's a lot to what that guy said. It just made a lot of sense. What the heck, India? What do you... this stuff, it amazes me because it's just like, oh, yeah. Yeah, here, instead of medicine, why don't we just change how you eat and you'll feel better? Like, wow, dude, my mind is blown. That was a good video. I apologize for cutting it short, but I wanted to say that if I held all that to the end, I would have forgotten because I'm old. I'm just amazed at, like, I'm just amazed. I'm truly amazed by this. This is something else, man. I got to go back and watch this and take some notes. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and we'll catch you guys later. Peace and much love.
I am pleased to announce that Dr. Squatch is the official soap of the professor.
Dr. Squatch is the best-selling organic soap on the planet. Make sure you click on the link below to purchase your bar. Feel like a man, smell like a champion.
Please stand by for these important messages in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, thanks for making it all the way to this point in the video and seeing us.
And seeing us.
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 The us, the Vester Bunch.
The Vester Bunch.
Now, the reason why we are here is because Movie Community College is an awesome...
They
awesome,
are the book.
Awesome
they,
reaction.
They the bomb,
term.
Straight up.
So, if this is your first time seeing them and you have not already hit that subscribe button, you need to.
That's right. And you also need to, that's right.
That's
and they
right.
need to also like the video. Okay?
Like it.
Go ahead and give him a thumbs up. Okay?
Leave a comment.
Oh, yeah, a comment as well.
Yeah, leave a comment.
Don't give it away that we was at the end. We want this to be a secret.
We snuck in.
Yeah, we kind of snuck in. I don't even know if Movie Community College even know.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, so
we
might better.
Tell them. We just kind of hijacked their whole page, didn't we?
Yeah, we did do a hijack. So we better go. Let them in.